Nat King Cole. Unforgettable. That's what you are.
Unforgettable.
He was born Nathaniel Adam Coles in Montgomery, Alabama. But at the age of four, the family moved to Chicago, where he was reared. Now, his dad was a Baptist minister, and his mom, Perlina, was the church organist, and she taught her son as a little boy how to play the organ. At age four, he performed his first song, which was Yes, We Have No Bananas. At age 12, he studied classical music, gospel music, and jazz music professionally. And at 15, he dropped out of high school to pursue a musical career. 1936, he joined Eddie Cole's Swingsters. It was a sextet founded by his brother Eddie Cole, who was a bassist. Next year, he got married at the tender age of 18, settled in LA, and formed his own trio, the King Cole Swingsters, later the King Cole Trio. The trio was named after that nursery rhyme, Old King Cole was a merry old soul. In 1948, he divorced his first wife, and 6 days later married singer Maria Hawkins. They would have five kids together, the eldest being Natalie Cole, who would follow in her father's footsteps as a professional singer. She made the song Unforgettable a hit again by singing a duet with her father's master recording of it. Nat King Cole had some of his biggest hits when he signed with Capitol Records. That would be the Christmas song, Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire.
Get your kicks on Route 66.
Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa.
Mona Lisa, 1950, number one hit.
They try to tell us we're too young.
And Too Young, number one hit for the year 1951. In 1950, he bought a house in the very white neighborhood here in LA of Hancock Park. The Ku Klux Klan left him a burning cross in his front yard. Also that decade, he had a short-lived TV series on NBC. When it was canceled after one season, when asked, he said, Madison Avenue is afraid of dark. But the 50s was his decade. He was super popular and selling out concerts. He worked with Nelson Riddle as his frequent arranger. He did a Spanish album called Cole Español, where he sang entirely en Español. It was so popular that he had to do two more follow-up albums in Spanish. In 1959, he won a Grammy for Midnight Flyer. In 1960, the popularity of rock and roll replaced the popularity of the crooners. He had his last hit in 1963, the Lazy, Hazy, Crazy Days of Summer.
Lazy, Hazy, Crazy Days of Summer.
Nat King Cole was a chain smoker, and in 1964, they found a tumor on his lung. At the end of the year, he went in for cobalt treatments, and he had to cancel a concert. Frank Sinatra sang for him at the opening of the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion. The next year, early on in 65, he had one of his lungs entirely removed. Even though his publicist said he would be back in no time, he passed away. His funeral was in February and over 400 people attended it. Some of his pallbearers were John F. Kennedy, Count Basie, Sammy Davis Jr., Jimmy Durante, to name just a few. 1990s, his daughter Natalie Cole with that duet, Unforgettable, with the tracks of her father, renewed interest in his songbook. This is Todd Pickering. I will see you next time in Hollywood.
That's why, darling, it's incredible that someone so unforgettable thinks that I am unforgettable too.